when Justice Reigns comes up to make his announcement, that's when everyone's gonna come up. So I'll give you the key for that. With that, I'm going to introduce you to Hilda Fontani, one of our great community leaders. She's going to be emceeing our program. Thank you.
Possesses all of the important characteristics that make for an excellent judge of justice. He's smart. He's hardworking. He's honest. He knows the law. He has a great temperament. common sense and fair to all the litigants. No doubt, that is his reputation. So I enthusiastically support him for the Illinois Supreme Court. He will make a great Illinois Supreme Court judge. Thank you.
And now we have with us Alderman George Cardenas. Thank you, George.
Hello, everyone. I can only echo the comments of his peers and people in the legal community. Phenomenal person, phenomenal legal mind, and one of many, many years. I told him that you should run for the Supreme Court as a stepping stone to win your office. He wants to go farther than that. We need people like Jesse Williams to fight for our no aspects of the lives. The law touches every little thing here in the U.S. As I see it, my opinion. All kinds of illegals that we've made over the years. I've been in the council now 60 years. Newly re-elected to the 5th party. And anything that I can, we do to make sure that Jesse Williams makes it to the 6th party. And I hope you do the same thing. Thank you.
With a mortgage case before him, and he, I can say, mentored me from the bench. Lots of pencil when I could do things better. But everyone has talked about what Justice Reyes has done and is currently doing today. Let me just go back a little bit over the history, the remarkable path that Justice Reyes has taken here. He started off, got his bachelor's from UIC, his JD from John Marshall. He's had a wide and varied experience as a member of the bench and the bar. He served for 10 years as the Chicago Corporate Counsel and was an assistant attorney for the Board of Education. He's now been a member of the judiciary since 1997, on the circuit for 15 years, since then the appellate court. He's the first Hispanic judge to lead the Illinois Judges Association. And somehow with all of this he's done and being 100 years old, he still has a full head of hair. As has been mentioned, he's been a leader in the community and within the diversity activities throughout this city and throughout this state. He's a founder of the Diversity Scholarship Foundation. He's a John Marshall alumni mentor, and he's a supporter of the Just the Beginning Foundation. He's a tireless champion for mentoring and the betterment of the legal profession. And all I can say is this is the kind of lawyer, the kind of judge, the kind of person that you want to have representing you on the Illinois Supreme Court. I'm proud to run my court.
And now I'd like to bring here the Attorney General, the former Attorney General of Illinois, Neil Hardigan.
I've never endorsed anybody in the court, but Judge Supreme Court. I'm here this morning to do that because we know well and believe deeply in Judge Supreme Court. not just for this particular position, it's important to do it.
Thank you.
one word in that sentence, one phone call you make, one person you relate to, one person you share with your friends. That's what it's all about. Hard working, hard working. Everybody's got 24 hours. Every 24 hours you've got between now and the election day, it should be the best I'm not suggesting to you.
Alderman George Cardenas-Mala, Ethel, and Neil Hardingham. Thank you for being part of the journey that we're taking to make sure that we elect Desi Reyes. And now, everyone has mentioned that Desi Reyes has been mentoring many individuals. Currently, he is mentoring a young woman. She is a law student at Northwestern. She is the future of the legal profession in Illinois. I'd like to welcome Emmanuel Jean Jax to the microphone. Good morning, everyone. I'm happy to be here. When I was asked to provide an introduction for Justice Reyes, I have to admit I was a little nervous. I wasn't nervous out of fear of figuring out what to say. Rather, I was nervous because I had too much to say about this really. Nonetheless, I will try to keep this introduction brief. Justice Reyes is a man that exemplifies his title as Your Honor because of his compassion and dedication to the legal community. I had the opportunity to get to know Justice Reyes while externing him through the APA's Judicial Intern Opportunity Program. As his expert, I not only gained invaluable experience in preparing as a teacher litigator, but I also learned of his work in the legal community as he worked before me. I learned that after receiving his first doctorate from Don Marshall, he first worked as an attorney in the First Division for the City of Chicago Corporate Counsel Office. Then, as an attorney for the Chicago Board of Education. He later transitioned to the judiciary in 1997, where he served as both an associate and elected judge for the Circuit Court of Cook County, and now serves as the first judge of the However, Justice Reyes' work in the legal community does not end at the bench, but also extends to his nonprofit, the Diversity Scholarship Foundation, which provides scholarships to diverse and deserving law students. As I said in the beginning, Justice Reyes is a man that embodies his title of Your Honor because he has been serving the legal community for over 3 decades. I drank to keep it brief. So without further ado, it is my pleasure to introduce the Honorable Desi Reyes.
Just kind of want to ask, first I want some of the women supporters, they can come up first, and so they're not blocked in the men's stand up, they can come and surround Jesse for the announcement. Literally get all around Jesse. There we go. And now I'm going to ask anyone else, if you wish to stand up and join. Come over here. Cool, so don't be shy. Big announcement. You can come over here. You can come over here. You can come over here. Squeeze in. I'm going to ask everyone over here to squeeze in just for 3 minutes. We're going to squeeze in. There we go. Excellent.
The floor is yours.
Before I start, I want to thank all of the speakers today for their kind and generous words. I will try mightily to Mariko's remarks. Today, I formally announced my candidacy for the Illinois Supreme Court vacancy created by the retirement of Justice Charles E. Freeman, a jurist who served his state with distinction, an honorable man who was a friend and a mentor to many of us in the legal profession. He will be sorely missed. As a descendant of immigrants and a product of a blue-collar family, I know of the struggles many people in the state of Illinois have to endure on a daily basis. I know what it means to have dreams, yet not know if you are ever able to fulfill them because of your circumstances. Circumstances which you did not create or cause, but circumstances nonetheless you must endure merely because that is where you were born into. As a child born and raised in Chicago, I was fortunate to be able to overcome these factors in my own life and was able to fulfill my childhood dream of becoming a lawyer and then having the distinct privilege of becoming a member of the judiciary. Think about it. One day I was working in a factory to help support my family. And now today, I'm an appellate court judge about to embark on a journey that will take me to the highest court in the land of Lincoln. As a result of these successes in my life, I always felt it important and incumbent to give back, to assist those who were seeking to fulfill their dreams. As a result of this sense of obligation, I have dedicated myself to public service. How best one can serve others than through public service. As a member of the legal profession, I felt I could accomplish these deeds. As I looked to expand my public service, I recognized that being a member of the judiciary would be the ultimate means by which one can serve. It is in this spirit that I seek to serve as a justice on the Illinois Supreme Court, because in my opinion, it is the highest calling of public service in this state. I can't think of no better way to serve the people of the state of Illinois. In conclusion, I wanted to thank everyone present for taking time out of their busy schedules to be part of this historic announcement. I particularly want to thank my wife, Terry, for her unselfish support throughout the years, and to my daughter, Renee, who could not be here today because she is teaching in Pensacola, Florida. And I want to acknowledge the second grade class, who many of you may have heard over the phones, who are watching via live stream. Last thing, I want to thank my campaign staff, particularly Mr. Ivan Gonzalez, the campaign manager, and Mr. Xavier Lagares for their hard work in putting together this event. I look forward to the campaign ahead, and with all of your support and God's blessing, we will be successful on March 17, 2020. Thank you very much.
Here, you're welcome to grab Jesse and take him to the side. And
yeah, that's fine.